I mean, have you ever seen a smaller?
Sure, it's like a micro. In the micro.
No, it depends on the size. Please.
All right,
the
May
face
West.
Face doesn't really matter.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Metro? She's Metro.
That was
yeah.
crazy. How was it?
He was.
Did he love you?
He loved me. He was the most gentleman ever. I was in
Did
the same.
Did he try to grab you and have a little surprise?
No, I said to him, go ahead, I dare you.
Anniewood. Guys, welcome to Anniewood. Some of the most amazing parts of this show that make me so excited are when I get to have my dear old friends that I just love so much on the show, and we get to sort of just rekindle our old love for each other. And this week is just that. We have one of my best friends in comedy, one of my first comedy papas, one of the first people to take me on the road. Actually, the first person to take me on the road.
That's amazing.
I learned so much, and I had so much fun with Jim Norton. And this is a special episode because Jim has just come out with his brand new marriage to, it's actually a year old, but they just started a YouTube channel with his wife, Nikki, who I absolutely love. And you'll see how lovable she is. You can't not love this girl. You can see me next, February 16th and 17th in Denver, Colorado, at one of my favorite clubs, The Comedy Works. And it is going to, the tickets are going fast, so grab them before they're gone. Then the next Anniewood and Friends is at the Comedy Store February 20th. Anthony Jeselnik will be there and a lot more. I'll be in Vancouver for two nights, February 21st and 22nd. March 1st and 2nd, I'll be in Fort Worth, Texas. Can't wait to be back with you guys. And March 8th and 9th, I'm so excited to be in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Come see me there. March 22nd and 23rd, Washington, D.C. And then we rescheduled those Jacksonville dates for the end of June. More dates are being added daily, so go to annielederman.com/shows and just come see me. I'm so excited. I've been honing and perfecting my hour for my special, and I can't wait to share it with you guys.
Welcome to Anniewood.
Oh, okay. Guys, welcome to Anniewood episode, Todd. 66. Oh, I wish you guys were 69. It would be so cute.
I know, it would work out nicely.
Oh. You'll be 69 soon.
His age or where
age.
You guys
His
always, age and yes. in the bed.
Well, you have a young bride. I'm here with Jim Norton and Nikki Norton. You may know them as YouTube vloggers.
Yes. Yeah, it's not where I saw my life going.
I saw it going this way.
Married and vlogging, but it is fun.
Married and vlogging. And now, okay, so what's the name of your channel?
Just Nikki and Jim NYC. Mm-hmm.
Did you guys have to fight over whose name was first?
I insisted hers.
Yes, you did.
Oh, he's so
And
good.
Then I was like, sure, I don't mind my name being first.
Yeah,
but Jim and Nikki doesn't sound, Jim and Nikki, there's something about the A-N-D and Nikki, Jim and Nikki doesn't sound as good.
I don't mind
Nikki
Jim
flows.
It does.
Yeah, I just like the flow.
But I like
your
Nikki
name.
And Jim.
Yeah, me too.
And we're going to get a little
And
dog
this is Randy.
Too.
Oh, you are?
Yes.
You're living in New York, but you like LA, you might move here.
I prefer LA. Yeah.
What do you feel about that, Jim?
I wish she would stay here. I mean, I like it too. I like coming here, but I would never live here.
It's something about, I feel a lot prettier in LA because the sun is usually here, not now, but the sun is here. The climate is good. In New York, I just feel groggy and gray and desolate and concrete. But if I'm here, it's a residential uplift. I feel energized. And I'm probably sure that if I lived here permanently, maybe I would feel.
And Jimmy has a beautiful apartment too.
Yes, but I'm listening to my wife. Oh, it's pancreatic cancer to be in New York.
I also realize, like, if I complain, I'm also a. So I try to not.
And if you don't,
wait, do you want to be a?
No, of course not.
Well
sometimes.
There's a dynamic. It's good for the show. Yes.
I don't mind it.
But if I feel a little lonely and I'm just gazing out the window, sometimes I'll be a little depressed. And I'm like, Nikki, you shouldn't feel depressed right now. Look at this life.
Yeah, this is a beautiful life. I met you in Montreal.
I remember the first time I met, and I'll never forget it, because we talked for like probably a good 40 minutes.
Yeah.
And I remember my life was kind of a mess back then.
Yeah.
And you had so much good input. I'll never forget that.
You were in limbo. Never. I don't remember what I said, but hopefully...
Very good.
Yeah.
You said you ended up with Jim, so I guess it didn't work out. Yeah, exactly. I said run.
Yes.
I said one thing. I said blink and run. Yeah. Are you okay?
Find a Dominican guy with a big who's a great pitcher. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, but it is weird. That was that Montreal. It was like 2017, I want to say. I think it was 2017.
Yeah.
Did I even live in Montreal when I met Annie? I don't
know.
No, I didn't live
when you were first coming over.
No, I didn't live there then.
Where are you from?
Norway.
Norway. Mm-hmm. And then you were what are we talking about? What do you guys share about?
whatever. All the, we,
now
we,
you can, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, we were just careful for a while, and, but now she's in the country. So yeah. Yeah, I was in Montreal for 15 months. But you went there just so I could be with you, like so I could commute up from New York every Thursday and see you.
I can't imagine going to Montreal for that long. No. Did you have fun?
You know, it was like the pandemic was like a blessing because we just got thrown into the fire together. Like we're just living together now, and we can't go out past 8 o'clock. But it was okay. Montreal was great to us.
Yeah, you couldn't see people were frowning at you because they had masks on.
No, yeah, yeah. But you could hear the occasional, ugh.
Oh, they're so disgusted with us. It's so crazy. They just hate our guts. I'm like, oh, Jesus Christ.
And I hate French. They all speak French. Oh, they insist on speaking. Me too. I can't stand it.
I just think it's so embarrassing to still
the worst language.
Like, yeah. Especially when you live right in upstate New York. It's like, yeah, it's kind of culture.
But I never, like, I've lived in Norway my whole life. I never planned to go to Canada. Like, that was completely foreign to me. I had a culture shock. I didn't expect to have a culture shock.
Yeah.
Homeless people and clutter on the street. Like, in Norway, you don't have that at all. At all. So it's weird that was like, can't differentiate what's a ghetto, what's a bad name. Where am I going to get shot? I don't know.
Now, what... Why does Norway not? Where are the homeless people in Norway?
I mean, there's a few gypsies and travelers and stuff, but there's not, I mean, a few homeless people, sure, but it's never really a problem, not been a problem. There's not one official ghetto.
Yeah.
Yeah, she would say, like, we would be going somewhere and she would see, like, a bad neighborhood. She'd go, oh my God, that's a ghetto. And I'd be like, you've never seen a bad neighborhood. This is not a bad neighborhood.
No, when I lived in Brooklyn, I used to live across from a, there was a project on one side and then on the other side, there was this place where the guys were so, I'm like, is this a halfway house? What is this? And then I finally asked them, I'm like, this is where they put sexual assault, all the people that
sexually assaulted the
perpetrators. Yeah.
Oh, sex offenders?
Yeah, the sex offenders. I was like, oh, cool. This is great. This is such a treat. Yeah. But there was like a nice coffee shop. They were gentrifying. So it was good.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it was a beautiful time. So Jimmy and I, Jim used to take me on the road back in early in the day.
Yeah.
I remember I opened for you first at Caroline's and I bombed and I got switched to Host.
Did you? Now, was that because they booked you or I booked you? That was they had booked you? What happened there? I vaguely remember that.
I think they gave you some like options of people and then you picked me to open for you. And then maybe I was a little new to be doing 20 minutes.
Maybe. You were funny, though. That's you were funny offstage, too. And you just, you said rotten shit, made me laugh. You were funny.
I was mean.
How long ago was this?
2012, maybe. Or maybe
is
even
it that long ago?
Then.
Wow.
Because I moved here in 2012, so it might have been even 2011.
How old are you?
Yeah. I'm 40.
You're 40. You've been out here for 12 years?
Oh yeah.
God. That's staggering to me.
She looks amazing for 40.
I can't believe how long you've been out here.
The Jizzin Jaeger.
You've seen another 40-year-old look like Annie? You look my
age. No, I know, and I have no work done.
Wow.
Not one Botox.
You haven't? Sincerely?
Never.
Incredible.
I will tell you.
We worked together for like 2.5 years, right?
Yeah.
It was a while. Yeah, it was more than a year.
You, me, and Kenny on the road.
Oh, yeah. Kenny's
Isn't
fun,
Kenny
right?
Kenny great?
Yeah. Kenny's, I just love his like happy demeanor. Yeah, I love his range.
When we were at the Ivy one time, we were all at a dinner table with friends and he was just sitting in the middle with a stoic face. And my mom had done, and she's like, who is this man? He's looking very weird.
It's weird you're like scared, but also feel protected by him.
Yes.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's like, because he looks like a Doberman Pinscher and it's like, he's the guy that you know could turn around and bite you, but he probably won't.
Yeah. I'm like, I don't think he's going to turn to me. I hope not.
And he's funny on the road. Kenny's funny. Did you see his movie Soda?
No.
Bill Burr did so this because he works with Bill most of the time. And he did this thing called Soda. And it's like a 6-minute movie for Club Soda. I just keep seeing my fat. but it's very funny. So you can check out Kenny's socials. But Soda, it's a very Kenny vehicle.
Like, I love it. Yeah. Well, now, okay. So a lot of guys will, in that seat, they'll do a thing where they put their arms in.
Here?
Yes, Jim. And they think it makes them look skinny.
That
We've
looks
noticed.
Humiliating.
Oh, skinny queen.
Wait, the most humiliating was when you were sitting in the middle and we were towering over you.
Yeah.
But I think you like that type of humiliation.
I don't mind that. Yeah.
I think that's the one you're into.
Yeah.
He needs a little whip. Like he told me once that Julia Child was kind of hot.
No, I didn't.
Big. He said she was kind of sexy.
I didn't say sexy.
You said she had sexy legs.
Whatever. Maybe she did. I don't remember.
Well,
maybe when she was younger.
Jim never hit on me, but now I'm thinking, now that I see what it's played out, he must have been really into me. My big feet, my broad shoulders, my deep voice. I have a little bit of a ball sack, you know?
If you had balls,
I have remnants.
If you had balls, it would have been you and Jim, maybe.
I don't. On the road, you got to, with the person you're working
imagine?
With.
Nightmare.
Yeah, you can't. You can't do it. It's just too much. Too much. What?
Randy. No, that's what massage therapists are for on the road.
Yeah, and the occasional fan who's like, who still thinks I have a future in front of me. And they realize quickly, well.
And then they're immediately behind you.
He's finished. Well, sometimes.
Okay, so you're in LA. I'm trying to think of what, I'm trying to think of old stories too.
I remember we worked together. We did New Year's Eve together. I remember we did New Year's Eve in Buffalo years and years ago. We were going to the gym. That was when I was really skinny, like too skinny
too
at that
skinny,
point.
Like AIDS skinny.
No, it was really troubling. People were worried about him.
Yeah, I see old pictures of Nikki and I from 2017, 2018. Yeah. And I'm like, I was fucking creepy.
Was
looking.
This like a little before you met me too? Because I remember when I first met Jim, he had that AIDS-y look. Like you just looked shredded. Like,
were you
not,
into it? Not, are you a little bit of an AIDS chaser?
No, it was way, no, like way too skinny. Oh my God. Like the neck. Like Jim, you don't. And he does. He told me he wanted abs once. And I'm like, Jim, you can look good with abs.
She says the way she
really. I didn't like the neck because you don't have to worry about it anymore.
No, believe me, not at all. Yeah, maybe, I'm just trying to yell
I like
ribbit.
You a little wide and kind of like a bulldoggy-ish.
Thanks.
In a way.
Great, great feeling for my wife. By the way, she is
more goldfishy, I would say.
That goldfish, I'll take her a goldfish more appropriately.
But I can't believe you fished your wish so perfectly here.
I know, it's I know.
He fished me in the Norwegian Sea.
He okay, so okay, I want to hear your story, but I remember you taking me. I went to New Brunswick with you, and you showed me the tour or to Vinny's Vinny Brand's place.
That's right, yeah.
And you took me around to show me like your hometown,
yeah.
But Jimmy's tour is like, he takes you to the woods where he sucked his friend's dick.
We drove past that. We didn't go into the woods, drove past it.
That's where he drove me to, and no one cares. Well, no one wants to see that.
It was better than when my dad took me to
show you where he blew people.
Yeah, I was not into it.
I used to sit and get the bus here. I was like, did you suck anyone's dick, Dad? The last home tour I got was a little juicier than
I mean, the amount of dicks.
I know.
It's crazy.
I know. It's just humiliating.
Well, I told you, I have so many like dick things in my house. I was like, I didn't want you guys to think I was trolling.
No, not at all.
We have like this dick pillow.
Oh, wow.
That we have like a dick. Everything's, you know, I don't know.
Love penis.
Yeah, no, I understand.
People bring you stuff, you know?
Yeah, it's fun.
We'll go.
Enjoy.
Oh, we know you enjoy a cock.
Sometimes, yeah. Depends on the person attached to it.
No, it depends on the size. Please.
All right,
the
May
face
West.
Face doesn't really matter.
She was May West to me. Yeah, believe me, the funny if it's big, he lies.
Old man.
Yeah, I guess so.
What is your age difference?
26 years, 29 years.
Well, 30.
Almost 30 years, yeah.
Well, for like a second.
He's older than my father.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that.
Did glad you added that.
Do you have a father? That's not his type.
I think that's why we work. We work, though, because I'm a very reflected person. Like, I know what I am, and I do feel that I have some sort of daddy issues.
Yeah.
And I do believe that that is why we work extremely well together, because I need that. I need someone who can kind of be like...
Yeah.
You
yeah,
know?
But there's times where we'll drive.
Is not to the dog, but like be a little like that.
Sometimes it's like, look, you know, I don't want to have. Like, it is what it is. There's a big age difference, but that affects us more than anything else. Like it's these life experience things.
Yeah.
But most times I don't even think about
you
it.
Stupid bitch.
That's what she says to me.
To
but I feel like we're really compatible.
Yeah, I think so.
Not my parents. They love Jim so much.
Yeah, my parents love her. I mean, the families are great.
That matters
a lot.
Because Todd's 11 years younger than me, so you're making me feel like there's
I'm in Madonna territory with what I'm pulling.
But I think your age too.
Yeah. But I think a lot about like what's life going to be like when I'm not with Jim because I'm not going to remarry. Like I know this, so am I then going to just?
These are the conversations
die,
we have.
I don't think. I feel like he's going to just.
But he's going to die before me, statistically.
I don't know, but look at him.
I'm going to live like that hamburger on the Obama's fucking, on their windowsill. They had that McDonald's hamburger they left there for 3 years just to, and it wouldn't rot because it was so many chemicals.
You just seem to be like, do you remember Pinky and the Brain? You could be like the brain. What was it or was that in, just like, it's just the brain attached to the, okay.
No, but
Todd,
I know
that's where the age difference matters.
But she says stuff like that. And I've always, the reference I always make is it's Livia Soprano. It's always the line of like, we'll have a good time. And she'd be like, I don't want you to die. And I'm like, all right, I got it. We know it's coming.
I think in the future.
Yeah.
I think very futuristically. Like,
but it's never happened.
So wait, how old are you now?
26.
You just turned 26, right? Is that a birthday?
Yeah.
What'd you get it for her birthday?
I don't remember. What did I get? She'd been 26 for a while. When it went away.
So oh, I thought you were saying she's for my birthdays, a bunch of times.
I'll just be like, just get what you want. And then I buy what I want. Oh, I don't remember what I got.
Yeah, I'm very bad with gifts. Like, I would rather, I don't mind spending the money on them. No, I just don't know what to get
Jim
people.
Jim is not bad with gifts. He has he's gotten me a lot of really nice, thoughtful presents.
What's your favorite one? Can you think of it?
There was one iPhone photo I took, which he printed from our view, and I thought that was, I didn't love the picture.
Was the view like?
It's a beautiful picture she took. But by the way, this bullshit, I'm not just plugging our channel.
The thoughtfulness.
We just did an episode. We just showed our first anniversary stuff. And one of the gifts I got her was a blown up photo. It was a photo she had taken.
Oh, that's
nice. And this whole compassionate, yeah. I love Jimmy, so thoughtful. She looked at it like it was a fucking dead animal. She did not love it.
She's like, this is not Louis Vuitton.
Yeah,
I hate believe me. Surprises.
Yeah, she hates surprises.
You hate surprises?
I do.
Well, that's why you told the tanning lady. That's nice of you.
Yeah. But I'm not a good gift giver. I don't mind.
No, you are.
I don't know what to, but if you tell me what you want, I can get it.
Now, if someone's trying to surprise her, are you going to tell her about the surprise?
Never.
Never.
No. Oh.
And he loves to surprise me.
Oh, he likes
unless it was immigration.
And it's like, he's like, oh.
Cutting something in half.
You'll be like, now we're going this place. Do you know what's crazy? Is that you guys are 13 years apart. It's just
the same birthday.
You July 19th?
Oh, I'm the 20th or the 19th. Oh, you might. My twin brother's birthday.
Right, okay.
Are you, so you're a Cancer too?
Uh-huh.
We're all Cancers here.
Oh, really? When's your birthday?
28th of June.
And that's why you have the ruby?
No, I just like them.
It's your birthstone.
It's not.
Oh.
That was what she got him.
June,
yeah.
In place of the other gift I got her that she didn't like.
Oh, you returned your ring?
Not the engagement ring.
That is fucking gangster.
I like the ruby because it's like pigeon blood. Yeah. They call it that. I like that.
Yeah, cold-blooded Norwegians.
I like that.
Yeah, she is. No, that was from another gift I got her that she didn't like. So she turned that in and got a ring. And then there was the fucking picture, which is still not on her.
Randy's got a foot fetish.
He got me the
my feet.
Perfect engagement ring, though.
Oh, really?
Perfect. I don't wear it that much because of crime in New York.
Yeah,
I'm
not going to
risk it. But it was gorgeous.
Isn't that such a weird thing about engagement rings? It's like you get them and then you can't.
I don't want to wear it anymore. Yeah. I was wearing it all the time. But then Jim is like, please don't wear your ring out.
You're embarrassing everyone.
Yeah, exactly. I'm trying to act like we're just friends. They are.
Can you flip it around, please?
No, but they're like taking it for people eating outdoors. Like the crime is so bad. Like, I don't want to see Nikki get attacked for her ring. Like,
you want to see her get attacked for her morals and her
100%. And because she's sinning in the eyes of God, and we both are.
I know God is upset with you guys.
Oh, yes. Good.
Were you kind of religious?
No, but Norway is extremely, well, not really the people, but it's like born religious. Like, if you're born in Norway, you're automatically part of the Norwegian church.
Yeah.
It's Lutheran Christian, the whole country. And it's built on Christianity. Yeah.
But your family was, when you came out as trans, your family was very...
My mom, well, I remember the first time, I was just very confused, but my family has been very accepting about everything. So honestly, they've been amazing. But my mom was just confused. She was like, "What? Are you a cross-dresser? Are you a transvestite?" Because she didn't know what transgender...
You're like, you're so close.
Yeah.
Just cut the word off.
I remember, like, literally, this was my coming out, and she's asking me, "Are you a transvestite?" I'm like, "No, I'm a girl."
I love the fact that your stepfather got mad seeing her stepfather caught her in the parents' tub one time.
So I've always lived with my mom alone. She's been my only mom in life. And then my stepfather comes in life a little later on. And he's a horseman, so he deals with a lot of hay, wears the work clothes. And I'm in the bubble bath in the jacuzzi at home. I'm like, 15? And I'm taking a nice bath. And he's like coming in the door. Pissed off, and he's like, "What are you here dollying up?" And I just remember just being so, that's not the life I wanted.
Yeah,
I want glamour.
Like, yeah.
He didn't care for you in his tub.
No, he didn't like. He didn't like me in his tub.
Makes me happy.
Yeah. Doll with a lot of soap and foam.
Oh, it's
feet.
Really.
And
funny.
I always have the postures. Like I ever since
he's
I was
coming in to just take a shit after
when
me.
I was like,
he's like, "What the?"
When
fuck
I was
this?
Six, I used to walk like this with my hand.
Yeah, and he's like, "What is this fucking fruit doing in my tub?"
Yeah, that's what I say when
she's
you're
like,
in the shower.
Put a ring on it the whole time. Well, I walked like this. I mean, I would have probably been the other direction. I like a nice trans guy too.
What's that?
Just a safe little man. Y'all nice trans guy. They're so cute.
I don't know that many trans men, if any. I know one or two that work where I work, one of the clubs. But I know a lot more trans women than trans men.
Well.
But I mean, even in
Tesla. It's like, you know, when you have a Tesla, you see Teslas everywhere.
I guess so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Randy, this is really.
I am enjoying watching your dog just attack
just here. Annihilate my feet.
He's, but it doesn't hurt though, right?
He's or like, does show it? That it he has two teeth on the bottom.
Oh,
my
right.
little Aww. Boy. We got scammed. We bought him for $800 and
he's
he is.
He's such a little cutie.
He was, should have been free.
Yeah.
You know?
He's adorable.
I know. I love him. So what kind of dog are you guys going to get?
I don't know. Something hypoallergenic. She That's wants one, but I know I'll wind up. We have a little terrace, so I would like actually let the dog go outside on the terrace, but I'm not going to get a dog and walk it.
I can see how it's
going to
happen. I can already see the future. Yep. What happened? I had to jump.
No. I was thinking of a King Charles or a Great Dane. Because Great Danes are very big, but they're nice apartment dogs.
Oh, it's so funny to get a giant dog and yes. then deal with it.
And now
it's good for the channel. You with a little dog's funny too, though. I like you traveling with a dog, like Eliza Schlesinger-ing it.
I'll bring my dog here next time. Yeah. On the plane, I'll bring my dog.
Oh, it'll be so fun.
As long as I have to take care of it. Like, I don't mind you doing that as long as I won't take care. I won't be the fucking husband getting stuck taking care
but
of the dog.
But I'm home all day. I don't have a job. Right. I don't work. So I want to have a dog.
That's
so I can
cute.
Wake
That's
up
hot.
And walk the dog and have something to do. It'll also cause me and give me motivation to go out.
Randy,
I'm not out in this city that much.
If they have to pay, stop. This is not free. This is not behind a paywall. They cannot see my feet.
Yes.
Do you want to get a job or are you enjoying being a kept woman?
I'm enjoying this life.
Oh, I like this. Yes. This is the perfect.
Yeah.
It's needed to happen.
But in all honesty, Jim wouldn't want me to have a job neither. He wouldn't be, he's a little overprotective. He wouldn't be fine with me having a regular like CVS job. I know he wouldn't.
It's funny
a CVS job?
Yeah. Or like something.
Why are we starting out with that type of job?
Like a pharmacy.
No shame, but I mean, it's
or like a normal cashier job because I don't have any.
Is that the only job you can think of having? Like Dwayne Reed?
Yeah.
When I think of a job, to me, a job is like you're working for someone in some sort of a facility or a cooperation. I don't know.
Yeah, but when you mentioned Jim would want me to have a job, Jim would want you to have a job. But then you mentioned a place that, of course, I wouldn't want.
Man,
you.
I don't want you working.
But you wouldn't want me to be outside in New York at 8 p.m. walking home from my job in danger.
Yeah, you take an Uber. And then you pay for it.
Yeah, I don't want
to. He wants you dead when he gives you the ring back. He goes, wear the ring to work. Yeah. Come on. I got you a necklace, too.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind her having a job.
Yeah, but, I don't want a job right now.
All right, good.
But I want a purpose in life, and that's going to be a dog.
Yeah,
it's going to be amazing.
The dog will give you purpose. I think if you like get a job, you should think of if you're passionate about something, not like
clock out. I've had so many people ask me, "What are you passionate about?" And I'm passionate about this life. I love my life. I'm not passionate about wanting to have a job.
I like this.
I went to photography school in Canada actually because I needed that for my study permit. And it's interesting. I like being creative. But I'm just done with it. Everything I touch and get good at, I just kind of get done with it.
And then you're ready for something else.
Yeah.
Good thing
or
you'll
nothing.
You'll never perfect this.
Ready for that or just leisure?
This is only getting worse.
I'm kind of like just wanting, I know it's just going downhill. I just want to go to like Turks and Caicos and these nice Cuba and just.
You know, the only time I went to Turks and Caicos was
Have you been?
I went on that heavy metal cruise with Big J. Did you ever do that?
No, but we did Birch Cruise, but I never did a music cruise.
Oh my God.
I think I couldn't do it when they were doing
music?
It.
Did you just have music?
Yeah.
Musicians?
It was like Papa Roach. It was so
Oh,
fun.
Instead of
it
comedians.
And there was just one show in one room that was the comedians. Mm. And then the rest was like big stages of, but it was really fun.
It was great, right?
Oh, I ate shit though. It's hard to bomb and then have to like get sushi with everyone afterwards.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was like, oh, I just was like, I don't know what it was like. Honestly, I think it was the reason I didn't do well the first time I opened for you. I was like scared of the audience. You taught me to not be scared. I like learned with your audience. Mm. Like I was like, oh, these people kind of like when you fucking hurt them.
How old were you when you started?
That'd be really mean. When I started comedy, I was 25 and I was like 26 when I started going out with you, I think.
Wow, was it that soon in?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but I knew you from the city. Like you were just a funny person. Like you know how you are.
Yeah, we had a good time.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, I went on ONA a couple times. That was really fun. Yeah.
Oh, you did? I don't remember. I did.
We did it with Alan. No. Not it was with what was the guy from Transparent who got in trouble for stepping on the
Jeffrey
girls?
Tambor.
Jeffrey Tambor.
Yeah.
He stepped on the girl's toes or something.
Oh, yeah. He did some funny humping thing. But he snipped at me. Mm-hmm.
He
was a little snippy.
What happened?
Something about transgender stuff. I asked some silly question and he got like a little righteous with me, but it's like,
I think I support a little more than you.
Yeah.
But we'll see.
Is he transgender?
No, he played a
transgender.
Oh, he's the man with the long face.
Yes. But I will say his face was quite long when he was talking to Jim too. Yeah. He's like, how do I get out of this?
Yeah, he was very displeased.
Well, I also am a little bit of an interrupter making jokes. So he was like saying stuff and I was just like, bink, bink, bink.
Yeah,
bink,
that's what
but
we
is
do.
This guy pro-trans?
Yeah. He wasn't being.
Guy, I think his like canceling was, which there's no canceling. I don't believe in it.
Yeah.
I'm done with this
talk.
I'm even done with the talk that it doesn't exist. Yeah. Let's just all just be ourselves. He got canceled for something like he got fired from the show for there was a trans actress that said he did
Trace Lizette, yeah.
Yeah.
And he was like doing something. Yeah. He was either making jokes or he like dry humped somebody being funny or like that's what I remember. It was something like that.
Yeah. That's probably right. They're like, why are you in such a weird mood? He's like, I did this radio show this morning and it was just, the guy just really icked me.
And the guy thinks he's an ally, but I am an ally. Yeah. I mean,
look at him now.
I didn't think he deserved to be fired. I mean, as an actor.
He was fired?
Yeah. But he's an amazing actor.
Because of something
he really
said?
I think he stepped onto his toes or something. There was something.
Physically?
I don't know. There was something.
I don't remember.
Some stupid shit.
I don't
shit.
Know. If being pinned against a wall inappropriately is a crime, then a lot of people I know should be in jail. I saw as part of the gig.
Yeah, but he's a great actor. Like, he was in Injustice for All, where he played with Pacino. He played the guy who went fucking ballistic and started throwing plates down the hallway. Jeffrey Tambor's phenomenal.
Yeah, he really
even though
good.
He snipped at me, I love him. I don't give a fuck. He's a great actor.
This fucking asshole.
Yeah, he's a terrific actor.
I also did, I think, Mick Foley with you guys.
Oh, I love Mick Foley. Yeah,
he was so awesome.
Yeah, he loves Christmas, which I find nauseating. But
that
he's...
was the thing where I was like, I know, don't mean to be mean to the nice man, but I was like, you either must or we're. I'm sorry. There's no, you can't be so obsessed with Christmas.
He's definitely not a so maybe there was a fumbling in his childhood.
It might have been, let's just say Santa used him as the stocking.
Or maybe there was a little, maybe there was a Santa's lap in the mall back in the late 60s, early 70s.
Which is, maybe we all have a little bit of trauma around that.
Sure.
I married Santa.
Oh, because he's old?
Yeah. No, because I give her shit. And I'm fat.
Well, he also has trouble fitting down a chimney.
Yeah. I come once a year.
No, you're not. You are not fat. I've seen you through phases. There was a phase when you were doing, you were like in a, you looked like you were in a sweatsuit all the time, but you weren't kind of phase. Like your body was sweatsuitish.
I don't remember.
Kind of that. In that phase. He only wears sweatpants.
Are you working out a lot still? What's going on?
Yeah, I've been doing jujitsu and Muay Thai. I haven't been going to the gym because I hate it so much, but I'm trying to eat better just doing that, and the cardio for that is amazing.
I really want to upgrade his wardrobe because Jim has only, like he has an insane wardrobe. He has the nicest shirts, the nicest piece of clothes. And he never wears them.
Because I'm fat. I tell her, stop bringing home fucking bad food.
But he buys clothes in a size small.
Oh, she's fattening you up. She likes you.
She wants me to have a stroke so she gets the apartment.
Jim, you're a medium. Just accept that.
No, I don't want to be a medium. I want to be a small.
See how he's more of a queen than I am?
I don't want to be a zero. I could be a one. I don't need to be a zero. I'm James Pearse.
Listen, I be the one that suggests Ozempic?
No, I thought it is.
Yes.
No.
It is.
Listen.
No, I won't do
that. I don't want you to do anything. I didn't even want him to go on testosterone. He wanted to take,
I debated TRT, but I didn't do it.
I'm on all of these things.
I told him no.
I'm on everything you're afraid to be on. I look great. I feel great.
You want TRT? Yeah,
no, I have some sort of testosterone. Should I take?
I want a gentleman.
Yeah.
Jim is a gentleman.
Listen, we're all on meds.
Yeah, I guess so.
Sorry. Yeah. It was a guess.
I'm on,
Randy, leave the gas alone.
He's
you can bite me.
Go on there, boy. I am on, I take a little Buspirone for mood stabilization. Nothing crazy.
Little bit, not much. Should be Valium, I think.
Yeah, a bit.
Are we a little bipolar?
No, I don't think I'm bipolar at all.
Control freak.
But I'm definitely, I got something going on. Bipolar.
You're a little OCD, no?
A little OCD.
A teeny bit of hoarding, collecting.
ADHD.
Bipolar.
Who's with the bipolar ones in the middle? Anyway.
Yeah, I mean, it's crazy. She's nuts.
Are you nuts?
Yeah.
Are you nuts?
Yeah, we argue. Yes. She cries a lot, even when we're not.
No, when we argue.
May I make a trans joke?
Yeah.
Do you put the pole in bipolar?
You put the one between my legs.
Yeah, it was a penis joke.
Lots of poles.
Randy, come here.
Oh, he's cute. He's very cute.
Aww.
He's got a nice vibe to him.
Isn't he
adorable?
So
adorable?
Yes, he is.
He's a happy vibe. He's got a tiny penis.
And he likes to be pet.
He does. He's a lover.
As he pulls his foot away from you. If he bit you, you know how happy it would make
me? He loved me before.
You're the first person he attacked.
He's so cute.
Oh, my gosh.
I would get one, but I just don't want to be responsible for it. Like, if you would take care of it, I would
Jim,
do it.
Jesus Christ.
You fall in love with it, it just becomes really easy.
Take care of it. Like, I'm home all day. I'm not doing anything else.
He doesn't trust you.
I know he doesn't. I know. Do you know that I've lived in New York, and for 2 years, I've never been on the subway. Not once.
That's cool.
Yeah, you don't need to. She acts like I don't mind showing her things. She'll say things like this, like he's never taken.
No, in the first year I was disappointed because he was like, "Don't go on the subway, Nikki. Yeah. It's dangerous." And then I was like, "But I want to see it, Jim. This is New York." But now I'm kind of like, after the Black Uber experience, I'm kind of happy that I'm not on the
subway. What happened in the Black?
Nothing. She takes Black Ubers. She thinks like, she's fancy.
I'm so glad she didn't say driver at the end of that.
I had one really, really bad Uber incident. I was in Montreal, actually. I was taking an Uber. And there's this French song that goes like, shit, damn. And he's just moaning throughout. I think it's Jane Birkin. I don't know. It's something like that. And he was just playing that song. And it was just gross. And he was just like, oh, so beautiful. And ever since then, I never wanted to ride in a normal car with a normal guy ever again. Black Uber, because then at least they don't even talk to you. And I like that.
So it's one fucking creep in Montreal has cost me triple Uber money.
I don't like going in a regular car with a regular man for transport.
I like that there is a no eye contact person. We knew there'd be one in the group. No,
Am I not looking at you?
I was asking earlier, I was asking him like if he's ever, because I was joking about them looking forward and being like, you can't look at us. Mm. And I know people that'll be like, you can't, but I did do the Uber Black, and it's my Quaker upbringing is like, be nice to everyone. You have to talk to everyone. You have to give everyone a chance. Mm-hmm. Todd is teaching me that that's ridiculous.
Todd's right.
And no, Todd's 100% right. Todd's bringing his Jersey, half Asian, half white trash attitude into my life. And he's right. And so now I'm like, all right, let me just try on setting a boundary where I go, no, they can't talk or look at me. And it's a fucking joy. The ride is such a fucking treat. It's where I'm fabulous. Not like, I would be just so annoyed. I'm like, I'm either trying to rest, meditate, work on something, and they're just chatting and it's a fucking nightmare.
Here's what you do. You got to cut that off when you get in. Headphones in, and I go, yeah, look, I got my music on, so if you need anything, just wave and I'll see you. Don't think I'm ignoring you, but I got music on. Yeah. Or, hey, look, I'm gonna close my eyes for a few minutes and just relax before they say a fucking word.
To sit in a big car than little, small passenger car. Yeah. It feels too intimate to be in a dirty car with a normal person.
Some are nasty. I will say, though, what I do miss when I get an Uber Black is the white trash in me, the W word in me.
Yeah.
Can't say it anymore. You know what I'm talking about? My Philly bitch. I love when you get in someone's Uber and they think they're covering up the smell of cigarettes with cologne.
Oh.
It is literally favorite.
You
it takes me back. No, I love it.
I like that smell too.
It's something.
Were
it's
you
like
a smoker?
To like, I was a smoker, and it just reminds me of high school and just like thinking you're getting away with something. I don't know. I do love that smell.
That sharp cologne smell. There's like, I don't mind a little cologne, but there's a sharp.
There has to be cigarettes with it. It smell. Can't be just it's, cologne.
But it drives me nuts how many of these fucking assholes think they're going to meet the woman of their dreams driving an Uber.
There's this one perfume that I swear guys wear a lot, and it's that aquatic smelling, really heavy. I don't know if it's
like
oil or
canoe
what.
Canoe or something. Maybe it's one of those aqua things.
But
yeah.
But they taste, it smells the same. And whenever there's a guy on the elevator, Jim can hide it. He's like,
that strong, potent smell. It's not like the smell of like Obsession or Polo or any other Calvin Klein. It's this sharp, it smells almost like oil that has been put on like cologne. Right. You need one drop of that, you dumb
I
fuck.
I just feel so uncomfortable when he has to like make them know all the time. Like, ugh. Like, Jim.
I don't mean
to. Yes, you
do.
They're not wrong.
They just think there's something wrong with him.
Yes.
They're right.
They're not. Do you think you have Tourette's?
A mild case, I'm sure.
Because I've been thinking, his mom was like, my twin brother has Tourette's, and I go like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I was like, I used to go like this. And she's like, you always do that. I noticed that. But I also was kind of like doing ketamine for a while. So I'm like, what time was it at? I was like, it could have just been. And then we were now noticing on camera. I do this all the time. And then I picked up, will you show that picture? I sent it to you. Or read out you could just read it. I looked at this thing today, and I was like, oh, no.
I like your dog. Your dog
isn't
is very
he so
nice.
He's such
even though he's biting my foot, it doesn't
so
hurt.
Friendly. I know.
He is being a lovely little animal.
Isn't he so sweet and
yes,
cute?
He
he's
is.
So funny.
Yeah.
Randy Jackson Quaid.
Yeah, it's very
It cute. Says, scientists say nose picking is likely partially to blame for Alzheimer's disease.
Isn't that hilarious? You just go and you're picking part of your wow. frontal lobe out.
You're digging the stem out and eating it.
You're just going, oh no. Is that what I'm doing? I'm like, I need to forget.
That's interesting.
Is that Alzheimer's? Ow!
Randy! See, every once in a while he'll get the angle.
Every once in a while he got the toe.
Ooh, got him, Randy. Got good me. Boy. I give him a treat.
That's Jim when I'm on top of him.
All right. Yeah, I don't want to. He's a Come good here, boy.
He didn't mean it, but the toe, the top of
I know,
the toe.
He gets that one.
The
part.
Delicate part of the toe. Randy. His little tooth went right in and
I mean,
got
have
me.
You ever seen a smaller
sure, like this a micro, morning in the shower. Micro.
I would say if he was a real boy, he'd be a school shooter.
Yeah, he would be an angry
he'd be
incel. So
he has no clue. He just doesn't know. He's blissfully unaware. Nope. Randy! You lost your
yeah, because it hurts.
Privileges.
I don't mind. I
Go
like
buy
you.
Jonathan.
I don't mind the hand.
Jonathan's getting 10% of this. Go bite him. Bite him.
Oh, if he bit Jonathan.
Oh.
Jonathan's giant
hog.
Can you
knight a dog?
Yeah, let him bite your foot. See if.
It's I wish hate. You guys saw the Grammys because there, I saw a theme of the Grammys, okay? Mm-hmm. It's people winning and then bringing someone else up with them. So like they brought up, so Jay-Z brought his daughter up who it's like, leave the girl alone. She's like 12 years old. I mean, she's like, doesn't know where to look. Yeah. She's just like, yeah, pull up the video.
This was yesterday, right?
This was yesterday.
I haven't seen anything from the Grammys.
I mean, look at this poor kid. Look how awkward she is.
Is that her?
Yeah, she goes.
Oh. Beyonce's daughter.
She's a little nervous. She doesn't know what to say.
She looks pretty.
Does she have her own Grammys? Like, what does she have Grammys
She's
on?
Pretty.
No, she's a beautiful Very girl. Cute. We weren't sure when she was little how it was going to work out.
Yes. Yeah, you never know.
She looks
Some
great.
Some kids you go.
Yeah, nah, she's adorable.
Yeah, she's so cute. But she just stands. It's like, leave the little girl alone. Look at her. She's got big shoes on. They say she's got big shoes to fill, and they actually put her in Beyonce's shoes.
Who are those two people over there?
That's Trevor Noah, who's hosting it, and then I think it's just the girl that
wow, does she looks a
oh,
lot
Trevor
like
Noah.
Beyonce.
Trevor Noah. Yeah, yeah, okay.
She's gorgeous.
I know Trevor Wallace.
I was thinking of Trevor Wallace. Yeah.
But damn, Trevor Wallace is blown
yeah.
up.
Yeah, yeah.
He could do next year.
I like Trevor Noah.
No, JC looks really good. Different too now. Maybe I haven't
JC
seen.
JC looks better. He usually has like acne and stuff.
He does.
I don't know what it's probably. Who knows? I'm injecting things. I don't
think
know
what it's
they
that
are,
money
so sure
look
are.
Because these rich men have that look.
They're doing something, but he used to have like, I remember thinking like, you'd think his skin would clear up with all that money and it has. Now, Beyonce obviously has gotten some work done and cannot move.
Mm. Oh,
She's in the audience like.
Really?
Yeah. I think they just get the facelifts too soon, you know, like too soon before they haven't like fallen.
I've panic. Been noticing that when I turned 25, I saw my first real wrinkles and I can tell that this is just getting worse now. I went to my dermatologist and he told me, look, I'm not going to do any preventive on you before you're 30. So when I'm 30,
Stop
the
pointing.
First thing I'm going
to
do.
Don't you point
is
at me.
That I'm
only one part
gonna
of my body
get a little
that's
shot.
To point at me.
Absolutely. That's not sharp. But she does it all the time when she talks. And she points and she's long fingers.
I'm a big lady.
I know you are.
Randy.
Come up.
You're delicate, though.
Come up to Dada.
Yeah.
Randy, come here.
But she's always talking about her getting Botox.
No, I mean, look, there's something called preventive, and that's right. what I'm looking for.
I think it's fake.
And every time Queen Elizabeth had a speech, she would take a little foot. I think I should take a little foot.
Yeah, but she wasn't 25 when she did it. She was probably 60.
She was.
But she was. They didn't have it back then.
Queen Elizabeth?
It's crazy what I live with.
I've heard this.
The first time when Queen Elizabeth
well, I've
died.
I've seen this too in The Crown.
She just broke down and cried in Rhode Island. It's just the
you
whole thing.
You cared about Queen Elizabeth like
yes.
that? Oh, that's so it's funny.
Because
I've never met one of you.
There's three people on my list that I really wanted to meet. Queen Elizabeth.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Putin and Trump.
Oh.
Number three of all I want to meet.
We can get you Trump.
Yeah.
I think Trump
she's had Trump.
Queen oh, really? You
yeah,
met Trump?
She's met Trump,
that
yeah.
That was crazy.
How was it?
He was
Did he love you?
The most he loved me. He was the most gentleman ever. I was in
Did he try to grab your other pussy and have a little surprise?
I said to him, go ahead, I dare you.
When Jim was in Vegas interviewing him, I had the chance to go with Jim and go into the room with him. And this is like you're being cleared by
Secret Service.
Like, this is a real thing. And I was literally sitting, he was right in front of me for 40 minutes.
You're Ivanka-like. I can see him being so,
it was insane. And he was such a gentleman. He was much nicer than what I was.
Yes, he's like 6'4", 6'3".
He's taller than me.
It was a sport. We interviewed him for UFC, and it was about sports, about UFC, because he was a good friend of the UFC. So it was a very easy interview because we were talking about something. It was myself and Matt Sarah from, he's an ex-fighter. Mm-hmm. Matt, myself, and President Trump. And it was easy because we were talking about something that all of us liked.
Yeah.
So there was no...
Spray tans?
Yes. And I couldn't really tell if you knew or not, but regardless, he was just such a great, wonderful gentleman.
He was very nice in person.
Quite passable, my girl.
He shook my hand. Yeah, but in this day and age, you can tell that this is a transsexual, and I'm fine with it.
You can tell now easier than you
could. I would rather be a transsexual than this trans. I feel more of... Well, trans now is such...
You could be... You can spot trans girls easier now than you could 15 years ago because it's in everybody's zeitgeist. Like back then, you're like, oh, that's an interesting one. But you wouldn't know. But now you just, that person's
now
trans.
Now I feel like, you know, a lot of the they and them also call themselves trans, but it means to change the gender you're born, right? Yeah. So it's like that doesn't.
That's not how,
No, that's not how I see it.
And then you're very ripped. You look great.
Oh my God. What's my body has never been better. I don't know what happened.
Are you Pilates?
I do a little yoga at home, but ever since I moved to the States, I don't know what's happened. My body has gotten skinnier.
Cut to gym like when I live. You have food.
Yeah, oh, exactly.
Two bites. That's it.
Hey, so you want a garbanzo bean fatso?
When I lived in Canada, I was a little thicker.
She's feeding you. She's your feeder.
Yeah, give me a bucket. I'm gonna throw up.
I'm gonna end up feeding you when you're old.
I know you will. Hopefully, some food too.
And come.
That was the joke.
Oh.
She does it all the time. I'll do a joke.
She's
very literal. Yes. I know. But I forget she's foreign because she speaks perfect English.
Thank you.
I forget that
a lot of people have told me that they didn't even know that I was not from the Americas.
Where do they think you're from?
I don't know. Like from somewhere in the
state. You could be like from Seattle or someplace. But I don't know their accent.
But I feel like I have a little accent. I do.
A very slight
tiny
though.
Bit, yeah. Yeah. But my English has always been good, I think. Yeah.
That was one of the reasons we were able to, like, you know, you meet somebody you're attracted to from another country. And they speak like, you know, Spanish or French or whatever. But it just it made life. We FaceTimed for a long time before we met. We FaceTimed for like 8 months before we met
sure
in person.
Yeah, I'm sure it was on
your faces. Yeah, well, exactly. Yeah.
Every time he calls, I go.
Gotta stay waxed for this one.
Oh, gotta shave my legs now again. And pubes.
Yeah, well, you stop doing that.
Marriage.
Yeah, marriage, yep.
Where'd you guys get married?
We just did. We didn't do a wedding yet.
Vancouver.
We got engaged in Vancouver. We got the marriage was actually at City Hall in New York.
Yeah.
But that was a paperwork thing because you know she had to be.
Arthur said paper and you paper the room. It's hard. It's a tough sell.
I couldn't get any friends who agreed with it.
Yeah, I know all your friends are just really very straight and narrow.
You'd be surprised how many you learn a lot about who your friends are and nobody has said anything shitty like that I care about. Yeah. But you can still tell who is comfortable and who doesn't like you can, people give themselves away. But we want to have a wedding. We actually want to do like a real wedding, but we just didn't.
Nobody wants to go to your fucking wedding after you're married.
I guess you're right.
You better make
I
it so
I hope you guys will because it's going to be amazing.
You're like, and we're talking to you, the Anniewood fans.
Yeah. This
we
is
were
not-
thinking about selling, streaming our wedding.
Really?
Make them pay for it.
Yeah. Or we would do like just a party. Like she wants to do a wedding, but I'm fine doing like a party where people just come.
I want to have a very traditional wedding.
We can't. We're married.
With the priest.
Well, it depends on which one of your friends you invite. I don't know whether you can have a flower girl or not. Get plucked. They might get plucked.
I don't want a traditional priest.
I do.
No, it just sucks.
Do you take this man?
We both look.
That's actually fun. Yeah. If you have a traditional priest that doesn't know.
Yes.
Oh. That's fun. It's almost like one of those hidden camera shows where everyone knows except one person.
Like a really old, like anti-LGBTQ, anti-gay priest.
Yes.
Hey, can you talk about how God will smite gays?
You will be obliterated in hell.
No, he wouldn't know. He would think like, are these two good Christians?
Oh, Randy's making
very devoted.
Yeah, I had to put my feet up just because he's chopping.
Randy, it's okay. Making him.
That's, I don't mind. I deserve it.
The whole episode is just, every episode is just.
That's understandable.
Like,
aww.
He was sick for a while. We were sad, except during the filming.
Oh, was he really sick?
he got messed up. They had to put him on these meds, and he was just like.
Kind of zonked out. That's nice, right?
Yeah, I was like, good boy.
Yeah.
Can we do this every once in a while? Can we do this for one hour once a week?
Sometimes she'll pass out on the couch at night and it's just great.
Yeah, you're like, ooh, more of this, please.
Yeah.
She doesn't wake up when you insert?
No, not at all. Not at all. She does this.
She gets it out of her in between her teeth. So did you guys meet on an app? How did you meet?
No, Facebook. She sent me a message. I get a lot of messages from trans girls because I interviews and all that stuff. And
but I didn't know that he was a comedian. I just saw him talking about trans people. I didn't understand that. Ooh, it was
she
probably
liked you for your looks.
Exactly.
Jimmy, when's that happened?
I didn't
want to fuck that egg.
I didn't understand that.
Is he boiled yet?
Because he was doing an interview or something. So I didn't
I think
even
it was
know
on Vice.
That. Yeah, I think so. I didn't even know that he was a comedian. He was just speaking. And I went to his first show, and I never really got that he did comedy.
It's the worst. She's the worst audience. Like by this point we had met, and she came to Montreal to see me. This is probably a year
it's
into knowing
around
each other.
The time when I met you, the first time, and just for laughs.
Oh, you were just meeting?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
No. We had met in Norway. I went to Norway to work just to meet her, like 8 months into us talking.
You were so into each other already. Yeah. That was really, really legit by then.
We
yeah.
had talked for, I mean, it was 7 or 8 months, and I finally booked Norway and Antwerp and a few gigs just to meet her. So I went
There's a place called Antwerp?
Antwerp, Belgium, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's it.
Diamond That's District.
But what?
In Antwerp, they have a diamond district.
Oh, I don't know.
There's just like one thing on their mind.
What's
oh
this
my God.
Completely uncultured.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
If anyone has any, this is a woman. If anyone has any, yeah. this is a woman.
Yeah, she said to me, look for the coupon code. And I'm like, there's not a fucking man alive that knows what a coupon code is.
I love coupons. They're amazing.
Guess what I'm doing, Todd?
What the heck is that noise?
It
sounds
like
something I love.
I'm shaking up our sex life.
With what?
With Via.
Holy
adding a little
moly.
THC. It's for him because I don't do the THC. THC for him.
Into the bedroom can totally enhance the experience. I love that.
Oh, their best-selling High Love Gummy will take things to the next level. Todd and I are finally going to kiss down there.
It contains aphrodisiac herbs with a low dose of THC to awaken the senses, increase that blood flow,
ooh,
and
to
add
the
intensity.
Areas, the cookie. To the cookie and the sausage area. I like the flow state myself, okay?
THC free, right?
It's THC free, and I like to take it before we get kinky, you
know? Let me get one.
Because I'm usually on the flow.
Let me get
one
of these.
I'm on my aunt flow.
See, I love these flow states. They taste so good. I eat one, and I go, nom, 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 nom.
And get to work.
Mmm.
They are good. Give me another one.
I got to finish editing the rest of this video tonight. This will help me get through it.
I don't have to do anything. Oh, my beau does so much. And that is why I like to increase the blood flow to his cacchino. Oh, you guys, we just love this. Via has tons of gummy options, both with THC.
And without.
And without. So no matter what you're looking for, there's something for you. Okay, we are we're a bi-THC family.
Here's the thing. They have a low-dose thing. Sometimes I take some gummies and... Boy, oh boy, am I to the moon. I don't want to go to the moon. I like to stay right here. So you just take a little low
present dose.
Or
so are you saying you're low? Normally you're low, so you just have to be normal. You have to take a little bit?
No.
So what you're saying is you're low. Finally, he's admitting he's a little low. He's a little low.
I just don't want to be to the moon. I like to just be.
Now, here's the thing.
Here.
I wake up in the moon. Okay?
And he wakes up on the moon.
And I'm on the moon. You know what's on the moon? A lot of shiny stars. I'm looking at them. I'm going... Well, how can I get my work done with all these shiny stars?
And the flow state.
That's why I take flow state.
It brings her back.
Brings me
to
back
the
to just regular world.
Each type of gummy has their own unique strengths and effects that could revolutionize your daily routines. This is what I'm talking about.
Whether you want to get better sleep, ease anxiety, take a little trip to the moon, Via legally ships in all 50 states with discreet packaging right to your door. No medical card required. Okay, so your mom and dad. You're still living at home.
or that nosy neighbor that's always like, what is this? What is this?
You go, here's neighbor. You're no. And then later you take the romance inhibitor while you're wanking to that neighbor, that nosy neighbor. And then also.
And then you go, who's nosy now?
Who's nosy now? Okay, now I'm nosy. I'm imagining you with your clothes off. Also, how about if you are living with your parents, why don't you take some flow state, okay? So you can focus on getting all of the stuff that you need to get done so you can move out of your parents' house and grow up and get a life.
Oh, my God.
That's what Viya does. It helps you get a life.
Oh, my Lord.
Let the gummies work their magic. If you're 21 and older, check out the link to Viya in our description and use code Annie to receive 15% off and a free sample. Ooh, I love free samples. Take your passion and your pleasure to a whole new level with high love from Viya Hemp. Ooh-wee! Am I excited at how young I look? I look so young. I'm such a little child, but I'm really 40 years old. Sometimes on stage, I ask people, how old do you think I am? And they're stumped. They got no clue.
And then they go, Valentine, oh Valentine, the day has come to love one another. Time, oh Valentine, the day has come to love one another.
Did you just rhyme love with another? Oh, you guys, do you know what you want for Valentine's Day? More than a kiss and some chocolates. You want some beautiful skin. You want to look young. You want to turn the clock back.
You want to look your best.
You want to look your best. You want to be hot. You want to be so cute and turn all the guys and gals on. So if you're looking to turn back the clock and get healthier, younger looking skin, One Skin has you covered. I do use this every day. Speaking of covered, I cover my damn face with it. I love it. It's so good. Their topical supplements go beneath the skin surface to target the cellular level. Okay, because the secret is their OS1 peptide. One Skin scientists found that it literally reverses the skin's biological age by reducing aged skin cells by up to 50%. Listen, you already know I love foreskin, but I love One Skin even more.
Oh, I love it. I rub it all over my body and I lather myself up and then I go to Disneyland and people go, hello, young man, have you lost your parents? I go, what? I go, it's very nice, but no, I'm here to ride the rides.
As an adult that goes to Disney. in a third-party clinical study, OS1's face moisturizer has clinically proven to strengthen the skin barrier, improve skin's health markers, and diminish visible signs of aging. And I am living proof of that. I use this all the time, and I love it. One Skin is more than skincare. It's about skin longevity, targeting the root causes of aging to help you look and feel your best at every age. Get started today with 15% off using code Annie at oneskin.co. That's 15% off oneskin.co with code Annie. After you purchase, they'll ask you where you heard about them. So tell them
we sent you.
It's time to expect more from your skincare routine. Invest in the health of your skin with One Skin. You got yourself a wife.
So we were in the, she comes to Montreal to the festival one year.
Randy.
And this guy, he's like, and that blonde you were with, she didn't laugh once.
Oh, that's while you were so on. Funny. I was there too. It could have been me. There were two blondes that looked like they hated you. Yeah,
there's two blonde trans people me watching.
That was fun. I remember I opened for you at that theater. That was really fun.
Which one? In Montreal?
Yeah.
That was great.
That was great. I think I left Jesus. I left my lanyard and you peed on it, I believe.
I threw it in the toilet, right?
Yeah.
This was all just for laughs, right?
Yeah, I took a picture of it in the toilet. Yeah, it was one of my better moments as a person. Yeah, that was the Jesu Theater in, and it's so funny, when we lived up there for 15 months, we were right around the corner from where the festival was.
Yeah.
And just having a life up there and passing the Jesu three times a week and go, I used to come up here and now it's just
I had my heyday here.
Yeah, I really shone.
And now I'm getting choked by this lady. Yeah.
I left everything that I ever knew. My language, my family, my everything.
Yeah.
To move to Canada with an American man. And it worked out.
I don't like the tone of that.
No, but it worked.
Canada with an American. It should be the Canada with an American man.
It really worked. I love American men.
During the pandemic or right before it?
You moved before.
That's fine.
And I would drive up every Thursday to see her for the weekend and drive home Sunday.
Oh my God.
Montreal.
Yeah.
And then the pandemic happened.
I couldn't even get a ride from the hotel. This is incredible. I'm just kidding.
I didn't do anything.
But you did it. You had a part-time job at one point and like, I wound up going.
Oh, you worked?
I worked at a woman's shelter.
Ew, why worked? Would you ever tell me that I had a fucking part-time job? It's disgusting. So I'm supposed to have no jobs. Okay, so this is what happened. He forced me to get a fucking job because he's like, God. You need someone to talk something good about you. Can you try to get a job?
You're battered.
And then, okay. And then I got a job at Canadian Red Cross as a phone thing. I fucking loathed it. I got fired.
So you were like calling people like to donate blood?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or, and those no, people donate are so money. Nice. That's so funny.
They are so nice. But
and
you have
the
to,
only bitch in the whole
oh,
thing.
Oh, she's the
but
worst. You have to
oh, they're read. So nice. It's like, I actually am uncomfortable with how nice they are.
But I felt like a terrible person for asking them for
right.
money. I did not want to be there at all. I can't believe you made me do that, Jim. That's almost PTSD for me.
Yeah, is it?
Send her to CVS. Give her what she wants. She wants and to work at Dwayne Reed.
Do you
Reed.
Know
just
how much money I made in a month? $400.
Oh, that's good.
It's
we're getting in trouble in the comments. Yay. Hey. She's an elitist. She thinks $400 isn't.
I'm sorry, but that's not.
That's how much I give Todd.
That's
a week.
Not what how I want to live right
now. I let
now.
Him smell my underwear for $400.
That's fair.
Oh, yeah.
That's fair. She would let me, but I just smell it in the hamper as I walk by.
I thought you're going to be like, I smell right now.
Yes.
No, I mean, yeah, you can just tell.
He just puts it on his face.
I was remembering a Club Soda Kenny moment. I came out, he was picking me up from, we were in Buffalo, and you got me a room in that really nice hotel. You always got me good hotels.
Yeah.
And
I try to stay with whoever I'm working with. It's just being the same.
Yeah.
I would hear about guys dropping their opener up in a different hotel,
yeah,
and I'm like,
weird.
Yeah.
I'm just happy that Jim is a man who treated equal female comedians. Just nice, right?
Yeah. Well, aww. He probably treated the guys worse.
I always felt like Jim was a girl's best friend because he has a lot of girlfriends.
Yeah. Yeah. I also thought it was really, it made sense. I like to bring a woman in front, so it's like a different, it's a full
totally
show.
Different dynamic.
That's how I feel too. Because sometimes they'll try to book me female openers. It's not that I don't like female comedians.
Of course not.
It's just, why are we giving them the same thing?
Like you want a different
not that
vibe.
We're the same thing, but like.
Yeah.
It's the angle. There's no way you or anyone else that's ever worked with me, Kelsey, like you're never going to cover something the same way I cover it. And I had guys work with me. Some were great. And a couple were doing things that were so specific and so close to what I was doing. Mm-hmm. Not that they were getting it from me, but I'm like,
I know. And you don't want to have that conversation with people. You don't want to tell people not to do stuff.
Yeah. Like, so. Or ask them. I would never tell. I would go, hey, look, I'm doing something. I'm shooting in 3 months if you don't want it. And people would be fine with it, but I don't like that conversation. Yeah.
That was the one in Vegas, the shooting in Vegas.
Oh, yes.
Why are you not in LA more doing comedy?
What's that?
You should be in LA more.
Oh, well, now you got passes at the Comedy Store. These
I know.
So they're like, finally, you finally proved yourself.
I don't know. Aww. That just came out.
I know. That's
No. That just came out. Honey,
she's finally cares about you. She's finally supporting you.
No,
I gotta pretend.
I don't know why they said that. I haven't been in there in a long time. I like those guys, and I would
course.
Do spots there.
Yeah.
I've said that they've been very cool with me, but all of a sudden I got this notice that I was now a past regular.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I didn't know, but hey, it was nice of them to think of me.
You're like, I wasn't a paid regular before.
I didn't realize that.
Wait, well, was I always a looser?
No, when I came to LA, I got passed right away, but I didn't know it was, I think the only reason was because I didn't know it was like a thing.
Yeah.
So I just, when I auditioned, I just thought I was doing like a regular.
Right.
I just did a regular spot.
You didn't
know. I wasn't nervous or anything.
Did you pull LA crowds when you were comic in New York? Is that hard as a New York comic to come to LA and do comedy?
Well, no, it was so easy, actually.
Yeah.
I used to love, because New York, I felt like it was a little bit harder. And I don't know if I feel this way anymore, but I used to feel like the crowds in New York were more like, really wanted you to, like, I dare you to make me laugh. And then the ones here were just really ready to be entertained. And it was a much easier.
Right. You actually felt here was better.
Oh, my. No, I liked New York the most. Yeah. And then, but I would come out here like once or twice a year and it would just be like, and they would put me on I was always like on shows with Louis and stuff. I was like, oh my God.
Yeah.
They always like threw me on. I just got on really good shows. And then, when I moved out here, I didn't realize that getting passed at the Comedy Store was a big deal until so many people were mad at me. And I was like, I guess I got something good here.
Yeah. It's also because you weren't nervous. You just went up and did it.
Yeah, I had no clue. And I'll tell you, if they hadn't passed me, I would have been so fucking pissed. If I had to do what everyone else did, I would have been so livid.
Yeah, but or you could have just waited until you were in comedy for 34 years.
Yeah.
And they would have just kind of said, hey, you're
on
best.
On a Thursday at noon, you'd find out.
That was a nice gesture. I mean, I like those guys, so it was nice.
Well, they passed Nate Bargatze like this month too. Did they? Congrats!
That's great.
This is good. How were those five stadiums last week?
Yeah, he heard it in an arena, and I heard it as they were closing a curtain in a club in fucking Des Moines. I'm happy for him.
Closing a curtain. They don't understand that. Closing a curtain. Yeah. Okay.
It's when you half sell a room. Yeah.
Oh, I love a curtain close.
I know.
I love when they don't have the curtain. I go, is there a fucking curtain? I got to watch the echo go to the back of the room and bounce back.
I love when I've been through a city three times and the first time the curtain isn't closed, I'm like, I didn't know those seats existed. I had no idea there was a back area. Just thought I was selling half good. It is a humiliating feeling when you're not selling tickets.
But Club Soda Kenny picks me up and I'm like a couple minutes late and I get in and it's like, he's like, I'm like in the mafia. He goes, he's looking straight ahead. He doesn't even look at me. He goes, if you want to work with Mr. Norton, you have to be on time. And I'm like, okay, I wasn't late again, but I was okay. Like, God damn. He laid it down.
He's very to the
point. Did he really?
Style. It was like,
no.
He's always so kind. So when he really like does give me like a.
Did he say it to you monotone?
He did. And he like looked ahead.
Yes. He also, he said to me when I used to open for Dice, I would bring my water out. And he would say, always remember to take your water off the stool.
Which is so hard to remember.
And if you forget it, then just keep walking. Shitty, terrible advice that I remember 30 years later. I always take my water.
Remember it?
Every single time.
I know, he's scary.
I didn't want to keep walking.
But he's not scary, but he's scary.
He's not scary, but you also know he means it. Mm. And you also know that he's like a hatchet man if he has to be.
And he's also helping, yeah. It's not like
but he gave me confidence, though, when my first Dice gig. Dice is very difficult to open for because his crowds are so aggressive. And after the weekend, Kenny's like, you were very entertaining. And when he told me that, it made me feel just as good as when Andrew told me, because I know that Kenny is not a guy who gives out compliments for no reason. Yeah. He just doesn't do it. So I knew he meant it.
Yeah. So if he likes someone, he really does.
Yeah, you'll know it's Jim. I mean, you've met him before. He's not a good bullshitter.
He likes me.
Yeah.
Me.
Hope so.
Better.
Yes. I won't come over when she's there, Mr. Norton. Yeah, Kenny's very genuine.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
Yes.
I'm trying to think of other good ones. I had a crazy thing happen on that New Year's gig.
In Buffalo, right?
No, there was another one we did in Vegas? San Diego.
Oh, the American Comedy Company. Yeah.
And someone had, what was it? They left their like room number. For me and the opener was this guy, Billy Bunnell, was also working with. And he was just this like drunk guy. Oh, this is what it was. Okay. He was a fan of yours and he left his room key for me and Billy. He's just like, I'm here with my wife, our dog. We have our dog. We're just going to be partying. Like,
yeah.
Come to the room and party with us. And we were like, it was like late. And we were like, should we go fuck with this guy? So we go to his room. The room is empty. There's literally a crate with a dog. And we find his book that he had bought of yours. And you had signed it. And so I wrote in it, like, Annie Lederman was here. We came into your room or whatever. And as we're leaving, he came in. And then I think the opener did some coke with him. And then that was the night. But it was just, like, so funny. When I have male comics with me, I'm very brave.
Sure. Stuff. And I hope he saw it years later.
Yeah.
Like, what the like, fuck is
what
this?
What the hell is this?
That creep. She was in my room. She took my stuff. It would have been better if you took out where I signed it, if you ripped that page out.
Oh, God. Just this guy sucks.
Would have increased
or I should have
value.
Said you were there, like in your handwriting.
Oh,
I came
yeah.
And I jerked off on your dog.
Yeah, I don't remember that. I remember the gig, but I don't remember that that night. But I remember we did Vegas together,
mm-hmm.
And one of the guys from Five Finger Death Punch came. Very strange memories. I forget.
Yeah, there were
a
lot of people. Rogan was there when we were in Vegas. It was Rogan, me. We were like in a limo with Rogan.
But did you go when we saw Dice?
Was there. No. It was like there was a UFC thing going on. But we were also performing.
Oh, did we eat?
Yeah. We ate with Rogan and everyone. That was fun. I think that was the first time I met Rogan.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Was I with you then?
No, I hope not.
Thanks for that. Yeah, you still talk about it every day.
Yeah, I would call
you. You better not have thrown a football.
I would call you up and you would go, hapa, tapa. No, this is probably 13 years ago. This is long before
I knew
you.
Were in high school.
I was a boy.
You were a boy.
And to everyone who
you're hot though, aren't you?
Yeah, and to everyone who calls me a man, I never got to be a man. I transitioned when I was 14. I was a boy.
Really? You did?
Mm-hmm. So I never reached manhood. Just Anniewood. And wood. Norwegian wood.
Behind you too. So Jimmy.
Yes.
As a husband.
Yes.
This is where you decide to start doing jiu-jitsu and
yeah.
And he's
you're
doing
married,
it too.
You're rolling around.
Life is good. Like I feel
Do
like
you get jealous when he's rolling around with these guys?
No, I love it. I love the more time I get alone.
Yeah.
She's especially in my beautiful apartment.
Going through all the finances.
Yeah, she's hoping I get paralyzed so she can hang up Marilyn Monroe shit to take down my fucking Kiss Destroyer tour poster. Bitch. No, it's like you get to a point where like we've been together for years now, mm-hmm. and I like it. I'm happy, and it's like I, you know,
I'm kind of settling into that phase now mentally, where it's kind of been like it's becoming so concrete that this is my life now. Yeah. Like I went back home to Norway not that long ago, 2-3 months ago, and I just felt like physically ill. I just felt like, you know, this is not my life anymore, and I just feel like this is what it is, and this is the person who I'm supposed to be with.
Yeah.
My parents know it. Your parents know that. It just feels right. It feels really right.
It feels right. Like being married doesn't feel like I'm not trapped because I wanted to get married.
We worked for it for years.
Yeah.
5 years.
I know. It was hard to get.
It was took her 5 years to get in the country. It was 8 months before I could meet her. Like, so you appreciate things when you have to work. Like anything else in life, right? Like you go through all this fucking trouble to get it. And you're like, oh, I'm so happy I did
that. Anyone told me in life that it would take me like 1,500 days to get into the U.S. as a Norwegian, I would have never, ever believed it.
I know. Isn't that wild?
It's crazy.
I wouldn't have done it. Like if I knew in the beginning, if I knew that you'd be rejected twice from coming in, I wouldn't meet you for 8 months. I don't know if I could have.
You like to be the rejected one.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm very used to that.
Give it to me.
Exactly.
Why do this to her?
Yeah, well, you're not interested. Oh.
You're that high.
What's that?
It's gotten bigger?
Oh, no, all camera
As
work.
He does it, it's always higher.
No, I do it
over
like
the
that,
years.
But I'm cupping the head with the bottom of the pinky. This is all empty space.
The thumb is like to make it look like got your thumb. Like,
oh, yeah. I just grip the tip and pinch it. It's tiny little fella. Like Clitty.
Oh, they called it little Clitty. Jimmy and the Clitties. That's his band.
I don't like the Clitty.
No, I don't like that either.
I have a cock, not a Clitty.
Sometimes the Clitties, it's not everyone's fault.
Do you like lady stick, she stick?
She stick?
I've heard
like
lady
that.
Stick and she stick.
Are you going to keep? Do you like keeping?
Oh,
you
my
like
God. I'm never going to come.
Have it all.
I love
have
my
all.
And yeah, I've been on hormones for 10 years and nothing can sedate me. Could you imagine if I was not on these hormones, what a berserker I would be. Oh my God, I would be fucking every day. Would be crazy.
There'd be homeless people all of a sudden in Norway.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she's, Nikki's.
Wait, where are you from? Norway, right? Mm-hmm. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
All of a sudden, yeah, people would be out of their houses, just walking around, bleeding from their crotch.
But it's worked very well for me. All these hormones and the way that I did it, I think I did it the right way. Because I planned to get a lot of surgeries. That's kind of like the code I feel in a way. So I was 100% sure I was going to get the facial feminization surgery, the butt, the tits. And now I'm like, I look great now.
You look amazing.
Thank you. I don't have to do anything, but it took me a long time to get to that point. I would never even walk out my house without makeup. I wouldn't do it.
Yeah.
And I mean an hour of makeup.
I would always talk about surgeries and I would always say, look, you could do what you want, but I didn't want her to get anything done. I'm like, I would always
go. Well, the ticket sales. The curtains.
I'm like, this is cosmetic.
Yeah, the only curtains involved in this should be the.
But I'm definitely keeping my cock and proudly so. I love my cock, my balls, everything is just
great. Instagram's very hot. I like
thank you.
It's very cute.
Thanks.
I wanted her to stay as she is. Like, you know, this is who
you
are.
Well, you wouldn't obviously be with me. That's what you wanted. Because when
he ends up with a vagina in the end.
But I play with it wrong sideways.
There's an Asian in the room. Don't be rude.
So yeah, I'm happy. I'm very happy. It's
and
I've loved all the women I've dated. I've dated some really nice people. Like it was never them. It was always me. I was selfish and I was shitty.
I think we really found
something missing.
Jim is my soulmate.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
I think so. It feels right. Like I don't want to get out of this. I'm not looking to end it and fucking sabotage it.
Yeah. I like you domesticated.
I do too. I enjoy it's like, you know, I've done enough stuff that was self-destructive and selfish and dishonest.
You're gonna love the dog too. He's so full of shit.
I know.
He's so full of shit.
The dog is gonna love him more than me.
But I understand the anxiety around it and not wanting to have like the other But you'll just love the dog. It's so easy to take care of.
I'm really bad with taking care of things.
Yeah.
Like I just don't want it, and I just know her. Yeah. Like I just know yeah. the shit that's gonna
no,
happen.
No, it's gonna be fabulous. I'm ready.
You're not ready.
Jim was also ready for.
Do you want kids at all?
No.
I don't think so. I mean, no. I'm kind of like, I try to think life traditionally. So I'm like, sure, maybe like. But I don't know.
She wants to hear she'll say things like, who's going to take care of me when I'm old?
I'm kind of thinking, who's going to get my jewels and everything when I die? Like, am I just going to give it to the Salvation
Army? Do you
have
any nieces or nephews?
No, I'm an only child.
That's fun.
Can you tell?
Yeah, she's
it's
not.
It's fun, though. I like it.
Are you an only child?
No, I have a twin brother and an older brother.
I love being an only child.
I've absorbed their children as mine.
Oh, you don't want kids?
We have frozen embryos and maybe we'll have kids.
Oh, you did that? My doctor told me to freeze my sperm. That's one of my biggest regrets in my transition.
I was like, if your doctor said to freeze your eggs, mm-hmm. we got to talk to this doctor. This doctor's a fucking asshole.
That doctor really knows the jargon.
Yeah. Oh, because do the hormones make you non-sperm?
Honestly, I don't. I haven't checked my sperm count, but.
Well, Jim can count them.
Yeah. It's a lot.
One, he has them jumping over
They all go down the throat. Swallow.
Over the uvula?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's out the nose. Oh, yes.
She always takes like one step too far.
Too far Nikki, they call her.
Yeah. Yes. But it's she's very blunt. My wife is very blunt.
That's good. People should be a little bit more direct and blunt in America because people get hurt so easily. It's ridiculous. You
blunt
guys gotta
the fact,
man up
the
a
blunt
little.
Cunt, that's great.
Yes.
The fact that she's not fragile, though, is really important. Like, Nikki has seen my material on us.
But I thought that our feedback would be a lot more negativity because I did webcamming. So I've had everything for the, like, everyone can see what I've done. So it kind of feel like there would be a lot of negative feedback. But the only thing that people would really say is that you're a man. And it's like, that's what you got. You're a man. I'm sorry, but you got to come up with something like fat or terrible nose. I don't know. Yeah. The man thing doesn't really hurt
me. I love that those are the things you think are.
Yeah. A terrible nose.
My terrible nose.
Yes.
You silly nose. You have a silly nose.
You have a sour disposition. Just the shittiest non-insults.
I can call the man too. Don't worry.
Well, I have I feel like I have good posture and facial structures. So do you, Jen.
Yeah, I have bad posture and bad. What are you talking about? This is how I know she's bullshit.
No, you've been better.
I have bad posture and a bad facial structure. I have a fucking fat, shapeless face.
You have a weak chin.
Thank you.
I was like, that's
shapeless.
Jim is super smooth. His skin is smoother than mine. It's crazy.
I love when you just give information about me that makes people uncomfortable. Jim's balls are nice to cup.
Interesting.
Silence.
And that'll be it for us today. So you guys are going to go do some other podcasts?
Yeah.
We got a few this week. Yeah.
What you got?
I did Fighter and the Kid this morning. We got Corolla, we're doing Dr. Drew, Tiger Belly, and I'm doing Andrew Santino, and also I'm doing Ryan Sickler.
Oh, fun.
It's busy.
Our third one
together. We did Whitney, Out and About, I think, on Barstool, and then you.
I wish I got you guys earlier.
That's okay.
We love you.
You had something come up that week. We were here.
No, he got sick.
Yeah, it happened.
He had the sniffles.
I would rather have... Do it now and not get sick.
Yeah.
Then do
I know. I don't want anyone to get sick. It's a nightmare, especially when you're on vacation. Todd, how much time did we do?
107.
And then I kind of want to show you guys these other Grammy things.
Sure.
Okay,
people kidnapping people and bringing them on stage.
Let's go. I didn't see
anything. The Grammys are crazy. It's just at this point, nobody cares about these fucking award shows.
No, they don't.
I kind of don't.
Weird.
Yeah.
Because it's all just.
I would have cared if I got invited at a table. Then I would go to the Grammys.
Jesus.
But you'd also be so bored.
Well, I would like to sit in that table for appearances.
So, like, okay, so do Mariah Carey, the Mariah Carey one first with Miley Cyrus.
Taylor Swift.
Yeah. Wow.
She looks so Mariah
Carey. Not a good picture from the side. She looks like a Maxell commercial.
I love the hair. I don't know. I love it.
The hair's wild.
Love it.
Okay. Mariah Carey's barely standing.
Yeah,
okay?
She's not on
She's
them.
On Vicodin. She's on Percocet.
But not Ozempic.
She's not on
Hey.
The only one at the whole place. She's not letting her leave.
Wait, she wants her to stay?
She's making her stay. Look at her. She's like, I've got to sit down. Do you see how she's laughing at the wrong times?
Yeah.
I mean, this woman's blasted.
She's reading the fucking...
telling a story, Mariah Carey's standing right here. She goes from one MC to another because their initials are both MCs. It's like Guys, this is not, nobody wants this. Oh, nobody wants this.
I know, you're acting like a DC.
She's blinking. Did you see her?
She looks like the aunt at the party who doesn't want to be there right now. She's supposed to go elsewhere.
I would say she's the aunt that's not there at the party. I mean, this woman is blasted. All right, her Spanx are ripping her together. All right, so that's the third one.
I never enjoyed her music, even though I think she, Mariah Carey.
No, I like her music.
You don't like Mariah Carey?
Get out, Jim.
You don't like Mariah Carey?
Hate.
Her music is good.
No, let me say.
Mariah Carey's number one.
I despise her singing, but she has a great voice. I don't think she
Why
sucks.
Why do you despise?
I just don't enjoy.
But you have no reason.
You don't like
don't
her
do your hands
color,
like that. No
but
one likes
no
it.
You have no reason.
You don't like her skin color?
No, it's not a black thing. I just don't like her songs. Like I get, but I know she has a good voice. I don't think she has no voice. I just don't, all I want for boom.
No.
The Christmas song.
I've never hated anything more. I hate that more than Al-Qaeda. Fucking
that guy. Okay, so the man who wrote that song is married to Katie, a comedian in town, and they are the richest people on earth.
100% successful. Yeah.
I mean, it's the number, it's like the most popular song that's ever existed. Wow.
What is another one of her songs? Another big song by her. She has so many.
Oh, You'll Always Be My Baby.
Don't know. I'm sure I've heard it.
Amazing song.
Why can I think of one? I know so many.
Exactly. But I mean, again, she's like, Gloria,
I love my
sweetheart.
Rock.
Just, I mean, I know every single song.
It's all terrible.
I do too.
All terrible.
I love her.
Unlistenable.
I was like, when all the songs were coming out, I was like 14 years old, going through breakups,
sure,
getting dumped after losing my virginity on a waterbed. You know, I'm like, this was just like the perfect.
Yeah.
It was written for me. But fuck you, Jim.
She hits the octave. Again, I don't like Aretha Franklin either, but I know she has a great voice. R-E-S-P-E-C-T
to be
is
honest,
a fucking horrible song.
I have some bad news.
Stinks.
I hate
She's
that song
away.
Too.
I know, and I wish her well in the wherever she's going.
I wish her well in hell.
I don't enjoy her music at all.
If you want to make it to heaven, Jim better like your music.
I like one song by her. I like You Gotta Think, which she did in the blues, which I think is a great song. Hmm. I just don't enjoy it.
Now, are there any female artists you like?
Sure, I love Lady Gaga. I think is amazing. I like Taylor Swift. I'm not a Swiftie, but I enjoy Taylor Swift.
I would like if you were a Swiftie. That'd be cute.
I know.
He is a Swiftie. He loves Taylor Swift. He's
What's
a real Swiftie.
It would definitely be the acoustic version of Shake It Off.
Oh.
She did an acoustic version of Shake It Off.
Did you go to the Eras Tour?
No. I mean, I'm not going to just stand there like a creeper.
It is weird. You kind of like, you as like a performer, you're watching and going, can I dive into the stage?
I was like texting
my mentor. I was like, they're really gonna dive into the stage at some point. She dove into it.
Yeah, but I do enjoy her music. There's a lot of female artists I really enjoy. I like Ana DeFranco has a song that I love, and I loathe the message of it. I hate
what,
the lyrics.
Women are strong.
Yeah, I'm like, boo. No. It's a message where she's covering which side are you on, which is a song about unions and workers. But she's very socialist in the message, and I don't like it. But I don't give a fuck. I like the song.
You love that Luft Ballon soon song.
Luft Ballon. Oh, yeah, Nana has one song I like, but that's not big. I'm not a big fan. Oh. I mean, enjoy that one song. Who else? Lady Gaga. There's quite a few. I love fucking Diana Ross. I've seen her in concert.
She's great. Yeah.
She's awesome.
What's the best concert you've been to?
I mean, it might have been when I was a kid. I saw Kiss in 77. My dad took me. So that meant a lot because I'd never been in the room with guys that I worshipped before.
Oh, but not like that. But you ended up meeting them and becoming friends.
Oh, I've interviewed them all. Yeah.
Well, Gene Simmons, I met over pandemic. How
lucky are you? Did he put the tongue through the little, mask?
No, he didn't ever take it off. I have a picture of him in a mask. I'm like, oh, cool.
That's we went great. To the last Kiss concert in New York. He took me to it.
Yeah, Nikki and I went. I got a ticket last minute. It was like literally 40 minutes before they went on.
That was our first concert.
I was like, yeah, I'll go. And we went. And of course, I was having a good time looking at fucking her, just kind of sitting there like, ugh.
I just don't like Kiss.
No.
It's not my vibe.
That's what you need. You just need someone that doesn't like anything.
And I don't think I even like going to concerts. I don't like it.
No.
Concerts are hard. For me, they're hard. I like to talk. So it's like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like full attention.
I feel left out. Exactly.
Yeah, I can't. I'm like, hello, I have things to say.
Yeah.
And if I can't go backstage, I've gotten to go backstage like a couple times. And now it's like, if I can't go backstage, I'm like such a snob about it.
Yeah, I've gone back.
I'm like, general admission. What the fuck is this? Like we went to Nickelback and they gave us, I'm friends with Michael Kruger, and he gave us like meet and greet. And I was like, this backstage? And then meet and greet, and then we just go stand on the, okay. It's like great seats. It was so nice. I was just like,
Did you go the meet and greet or no?
Yeah, we went to the meet and greet.
Yeah.
But I wanted a little more attention. Mm-hmm.
I have to be able to go back comfortably or I don't want to go either the same way. But I always feel like a loser. Like, I mean, I've been lucky enough to, you know, gotten to know Ozzy over the years. And I've actually gotten to go to a Sabbath concert in the car with Ozzy. Like, yeah. Where it's me and him and his security people driving an hour to the show in Anaheim.
Have you ever gone like you feel like you've made it? I mean,
no.
Career for 30 years. I feel like he should feel a little bit like sometimes I've made it.
Well, he's the best type of star fucker. And I always appreciated this because you kind of give me permission to be like this. You get so excited to meet people, take pictures with them.
Yes.
And it's like, it's so, and not a star fucker in the way that you're like, you're not kissing their ass in any way that's not genuine, but I like love it.
Our hallway is full of just celebrities that he's taking pictures with.
Well, I mean, when I meet people, and it can be random, I mean, there's certain people where I'm just like, I always am like so over the top. Like,
yes.
I'm weak in the knees, I'm dying.
Yeah, I've gotten some
interesting. It's like John Lovitz. I'm like, John Lovitz, I can't, like, I do it nuts when I meet. There's just certain people that I go crazy with.
I got Pele, and I don't watch soccer, but it's fucking Pele. Yeah. But anyway, when I go with Ozzy, even I have backstage access. But like he's in there doing his vocal warm-ups and people are eating.
Yeah.
And I just feel like a dick. No. So even though I have the access, I'm like, what do I do? Where do I stand? I don't belong here. I'm not doing anything.
I'm an asshole because if people ask me if they're like, can I come back in the room? I'm like, what are you talking about? You can come back in the green room. I'm about to go on stage.
Yeah.
So I understand it and I shouldn't be wanting this, but it's more to reject it and go, no, I couldn't.
Yeah, I know. I like going backstage. I like it. I don't have to go back to catering. I never feel like I should be eating their food.
Yeah.
But I really do feel worthless when I go. But as much as the high of going to the show with him.
It is interesting, though, to see, because what we do is so different from what they do, but it's like still in venues and stuff like that. So it's interesting to see how it is for them. They have to do so many more sound checks and so many crazier things.
Yeah.
It was fun. We had fun.
Jim's never going to settle down properly. Like, just relax. He'll never be the man to go in a cabin and just unwind.
Stop with the cabin.
No, he might go to a cabin in Norway. He just won't be leaving the cabin. He'll hang out, man.
I would love a little cabin.
All right, yeah, you should
get one.
You'll
have your very own cabin. There'll be a body you'll have to dispose of. But
yeah, I don't want to. She wants me to get a cabin in Norway. I don't want that.
It's 50% of Norwegians own cabins, so Jim should get one. And it doesn't.
No,
it
Todd's would suck. Kind of like this, too. Todd, what did you say last night? Where did you want to move?
To like the Japanese like country side.
No. Yeah. I've always wanted to live in Amsterdam. Oh, like Amsterdam.
Why? You really have to ask why?
I just got him a passport. I literally, he's never gone anywhere. I'm like, wow. He's like, you know, my dream's always been to live in Amsterdam.
Have you never been out of the States?
I've been to Canada.
Canada. Yeah. He got to go to Tammy in
Toronto and watch some homeless people fight in the McDonald's.
How'd you like leaving the country?
It's annoying. It's a pain in the ass.
Yeah.
And I'm like kind of scared. I watch like Hostel and I get like scared of some of those European countries.
Yeah. It's also weird too. Canada feels so much like the U.S. Like when you go to Toronto, it's like a northern city.
It's a little weird though. It's always a little different.
A little bit.
Have you been to Europe?
I went to Europe. Did you ever do the Vodafone Comedy Festival in Dublin?
I've unfortunately never been invited. To participate.
Well,
in that.
I keep every time the Melbourne one comes up, I'm like, still not invited.
I've gone to Melbourne
in
Sydney.
I'm friends with a guy, Sebastian, that runs it. I'm like, hello, where are we?
Yeah, I think I actually did do that, but I didn't. Sydney had something where they put me on some show in the Opera House with other people. Mm-hmm. It was a TV taping that went moderately average.
Oh, those TV tapings are so stressful. But then you'll never see them. So.
No, I never do. I'll see like a Montreal one I taped 11 years ago. I'm like, oh, I forgot I did that. Like it was one of me and Bob Saget where he's introducing me. I'm like, and I knew Bob, but I was like, wow, I forgot we did that.
Yeah.
I forgot he did that and let me be on it. Yeah, let me correct myself.
He remembered and he threw his head back. He said, ah!
Yeah, he
bashed his head into the wall.
He's like, I can't believe I helped that piece of shit.
Oh, I miss Jimmy. Nobody's mean anymore. It's so annoying.
I know.
Everyone's so nice. And then you're like, and you're so cool.
You should see us behind closed doors.
But thank you for being like this because I was like, are you guys coming? And then I was like, she's not going to care. And he goes, no.
What?
If I said guys or whatever, it's like,
no, it's a colloquial expression.
Oh, thank you for being regular.
And by the way,
cool.
To anyone who's trans, by the way, I want to go to a store and someone says, bye, guys. Anyone who's annoyed at that, like, what are you annoyed at?
It's a colloquial.
What do you expect them to go, hello, madams? Like, come on. It's not 1940s.
And it's the way we talk. Like, when you see a group of people, you go, where are you guys going? It's not broken down by gender. No one's thinking that. No,
I don't want anyone to be scared of me. And like, if I get a spray tan, I always tell them because I don't want them to be, oh, and then pretend that they're not comfortable. I just always tell them.
Yeah.
Yes.
I know. It's we watch Survivor. We love the show Survivor. And Jeff Probst, the host, like 3 seasons ago, he always goes, hey,
it's
guys.
It's a hard name to say. B-S-T.
Oh, I listen. It's,
thank God for that O.
It's in me. So he addresses the group and he goes, I actually wanted to see, is everyone comfortable with me saying guys? And one person goes, as an ally, I'm not, and it's not even the gay person God. On the.
Of course.
As an ally.
Like, it's just like, just let things be easy.
Yeah. What does that mean? Like, does that mean you're my friend? But I don't even know you. Why do you have to be my ally? I don't even fucking know you.
It doesn't
mean. And then an ally doesn't know what your specific.
Yeah, an ally means fucking zero.
And by the way, an ally is not about the person. It's about me saying I'm an ally.
Right.
I'd like a little credit, please.
Yes, you know, I'm an ally.
You know how fraudulent people are with being allies? Yeah. Again, I know through what she and I do, the way people react to us, and like you fucking people, you're full of shit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Fuck you. Mm-hmm. You're ally nonsense.
Yeah.
Stop it.
I mean, here's Jim, who's married someone in the biz. I can't think of one man or person in the biz, in the industry, who has married anyone transgender. There's not one.
If there is,
it's behind closed doors and not in media, so then I don't think you're that much in the industry. But Jim,
you're outing people.
Where's
here?
All the allies, guys? I don't see that many rainbows.
Yeah, where are the rainbows?
Where are the fucking rainbows?
Yeah, I don't care. But I just whenever I hear that, people say I'm an ally,
and we just talked about Trump. I'm not a conservative. Like just because I met Trump through my husband, I'm gonna be a conservative, guys. I'm not a conservative.
Yeah, people just like to put you somewhere where they can feel comfortable. Okay, this is what this person is.
I just don't care about your politics.
We're just, it's boring. Care. I don't care either.
I know, I've tapped out. My dad, it's like, I'm like, Dad, my dad's 82. You met my parents.
Yep.
Do you remember my parents?
Very nice.
And
are they old school?
The pig.
No, they're like, they're liberal, but it's like, they're Quakers. So they're brought up Quakers.
What's Quaker? Just, is that
Quakers like that there's good in everyone, and it's just how your daughter gets diddled. It's just they're like, hey, dangerous man, do you want to babysit our kid?
Yeah. He doesn't want son to get on those, so he blacks out the van windows.
Everybody hates this van guy. You know what I have? I'm going to trust you with our children.
Yeah, exactly.
But they're just like my dad, I call him today and he's watching the news. I go, when have you been happy watching the news? Mm. He goes, when Trump lost, I go, that was one time. It's like, you're 82. Like, go on a walk. You love nature. Go look at a tree.
Mm-hmm.
Go hang out with mom. Like, what are you doing?
The news here is really different than it is in Norway. Because here it's like you either have Fox or CNN, I feel. And it's like a show. You know, in Norway, we literally watched a PBS channel.
It's just very bland news.
Yeah, but that's what people watch in Norway, you know? Like, hello, today.
Like, we have a new statistic. Today, 50% of Norwegians have cabins.
Today,
so make sure to get your Norwegian wife one.
Yes.
Today, the weather is nice and little crime in Oslo.
Yes.
There's a bit of crime.
Yes. And somebody who did not have blue eyes entered the country.
Todd and I were watching, we were going on YouTube, we're watching vlogs of people walking through like Tokyo. And where did we watch? Walk through Switzerland? And Todd was just making so many jokes about all the white people.
Yeah.
There's another white person, a white person here, a white person there.
We've been to Switzerland and I want to go to Japan too. Like I want to go to that.
Yes, really.
That Jiro's place, that sushi place. It's supposed to be the best sushi in the world.
Tsukiyabashi or something. Konnichiwa.
No. So what is that?
You would kill in Japan.
I know. It's called...
You're like so perfect for Japan.
No, it's called Jiro. It's a great sushi place.
But yeah, I love sushi.
Don't marry a woman. And then be a woman. You're like mad for being like such a girl. It's like, oh, can you be more masculine?
I am in his mouth.
The important part.
Yeah, there's times where
sometimes I slap one of them.
Yeah, she's not really ladying it up at times. But look, it works. You know, I could not have married anybody who thinks differently than Nikki. I just couldn't. Yeah. Like, it's fun. I'm not worried I'm going to say something that's going to be...
We've always had fun. I mean, we lived secretly for freaking 5 years.
Yeah, and the pandemic, but not too. So it's much like, fun. That's how we were, too. We were together the entire time. Yeah. We were laughing the whole time.
That's great.
But it's not secret, like, among our friends. Like, my friends are family. Yeah, it wasn't like, I was like, I don't want people to know.
No.
She was immigrating, and we wanted to get it done, and I didn't want to adjudicate it on the air.
Laying low and, you know, didn't really want people to make speculations about things they have no idea of.
And if she didn't get in, I didn't want to have to deal with it on the radio. So, you know, it's just too much. You're annoying.
Yes.
We broke up.
Yeah. Yeah. So I just couldn't do it.
Rope.
I love when you say just awkward.
All right.
That's perfect. The last thing you're going to say is rope. Mm-hmm. You know what?
And good. We do get it. We do like get it.
And that's how it ends for us.
Hopefully not.
In that cabin. There's one rope.
Yeah.
One rope, two cocks, one man.
Yes.
You guys, that's a new riddle. Okay. Yes. All right, you guys can watch Nikki and Jim.
NYC on NYC. YouTube. And I'm on tour.
NYC, eh?
Yes. We did, yeah. Just oh, shit.
I was really shaming you. Oh, you're so sweet.
I have never been happier. Oh, I wish it was hot.
Annie, now you need a professional carpet cleaning.
No, I have. No, this is that I can do.
The coffee always sucks.
No, it's okay. He'll clean it. I was watching that the entire
time. Oh
well, yeah,
it's his job to keep me.
Well, I'll be honest. I'm just.
How many sips of coffee did you take?
Two.
I actually didn't.
Konnichiwa.
Yes, konnichiwa. I didn't have my coffee because I would be pissing my pants here.
I would. I would go to Japan with you guys.
I would love to.
I would love.
We should do a Japan show or something.
Oh my
to
god!
Make it. Do you travel without work? It's hard for me to do that.
I do occasionally with Nikki because I'm so happy to we're
and
doing
we
stuff.
We love to travel. Yeah. I would fucking love to go to Japan with you. Sushi.
Yeah, it'd be so fun.
Laugh.
Can I just say one thing that's so disappointing about this falling? It didn't get on Jonathan, did it?
No, unfortunately not.
Can you imagine it just splattered all over him?
All over his
face.
Oh
my god.
Coffee.
It was acid.
Don't you feel like Jonathan's one of the type of guys that like takes his jeans to get dry cleaned?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, because there's a big bulge stain in the front. a big bulge imprint.
Do you want to plug anything?
Just the tour. There's a horrible tour photo of me. It's not the photographer's fault. I look like a fat pig.
Why'd you pick it?
Because it was the least worst one. I have to get another picture taken soon. JimNorton.com. I had a bunch of dates coming up. And Nikki and Jim NYC. Hopefully you like the YouTube channel.
Yeah, I would make fun of it for a second, but then I can't pay for all of the carpet cleaning. I can't afford what else would happen. I made fun of him.
That's right. That's character.
Yeah. That's what we say about the chin. Anyway, guys, thank you for coming.
Oh, we love you. Thank you.
Was
this
so
was fun.
Great. We'll see you in Japan.
Yes, let's do it.
We really do. We love each other.
It's the meat and potatoes.
Welcome to Anniewood. This is the land of the Stannies, Annies, and Fannies, and all of the Zeefa Nannies. Yeah. Welcome to Anniewood. This is the land of the Stannies, Annies, and Fannies, and all of the Zeefa Nannies. I'm going off ayahuasca. I'm about to prosper. Blingy on my drinking, and Randy is living proper. Protector of the sea, she never let her fishes die. Never known to tell a lie, she even fixed Todd's eyes. Shout out to the slugs, shout out Woody's too. Shout out Esty and Kalila and the Anniewood crew. Cause this is Anniewood, you know that this is how I'm living. Real and never pretending shit, you know that it's a gift. Welcome to Anniewood. This is the land of the Stannies, Annies, and Fannies, and all of the Zeefa Nannies.